Hello, everybody, and greetings from the Delta College Planetarium. My name is Brian, and I'm here to bring you the next episode in our series about the constellations. Last time, we looked at how to find the Autumn Square and the constellation Pegasus. The constellation we'll look for today actually shares a star with Pegasus. Remember that the Autumn Square is made from four stars in nearly a perfect square, which is high overhead in the fall. The stars on the right side of the square form the head and legs of Pegasus. We're going to turn our attention then to the left-hand side of the square. In particular, we're going to look at the upper left corner star of the square. Take a moment and explore the other stars around this star. You'll notice that there's a line of three stars coming off that corner star, and just above them, there's another line of three stars. These are much dimmer, but they're in nearly the same spacing. Taken together, these lines form a curved V-shape. This sweeping V-shape forms the body of Princess Andromeda. Andromeda is the princess of ancient Ethiopia, which is not related to modern Ethiopia. And she's being offered as sacrifice to Poseidon, the Greek god of the sea and storms. The V-shape forms her body. The vertex of the V is her head, and the ends are her feet. A line of stars cuts across the top of her body, forming her arms, which are chained to a rock, awaiting a sea monster sent to execute Poseidon's will. There's a significant object visible in Andromeda. Look for the V that forms Andromeda's body. Starting from the head, follow the brighter line, that lower line of stars, out two stars. From there, draw a path to the corresponding star in the dimmer line, the upper line of stars, and continue that line out by about the distance between those stars again. Under dark skies, you may see a faint gray glow here, like a smudge. It may be easier to see using averted vision, that is to say, by looking near it but not at it. This object was known as the Great Andromeda Nebula. Visible to the eye under dark skies, the Andromeda Nebula was known since antiquity. William Herschel suspected that the Andromeda Nebula was the nearest nebula to Earth, which would account for its size and brightness. As telescopes became better, a spiral became visible in the nebula. Various other spiral nebulae were discovered in the sky, but their nature eluded astronomers. 100 years ago, one of the central questions of astronomy was, are the spiral nebulae within the Milky Way, or do they lie outside the galaxy? There were those who believed that the Milky Way constituted the entire universe. The spiral nebulae were perhaps stars in the process of forming. Maybe they were in the initial stages of creating planetary systems like our own. This way of thinking wasn't without evidence. If the spiral nebulae were outside the Milky Way, then they should be found everywhere in the sky. But astronomers only ever found them above or below the plane of the Milky Way. Why should anything outside the galaxy avoid this zone of the sky? In 1885, there was a nova in the Andromeda Nebula. A dim star rapidly brightened to 1/10 the brightness of the entire nebula. If the nebula were outside the Milky Way, it would have had to have been brighter than billions of stars to be as bright as observed, which seems preposterous. The other side countered that the Andromeda Nebula had many more novae than the rest of the Milky Way, although they were far fainter. Why would one nebula in the Milky Way have so many novae? And the spiral nebulae appeared to have dark lanes, very similar to the dark lanes of dust we observe in the Milky Way. Perhaps the spiral nebulae were themselves like the Milky Way, independent galaxies composed of billions of stars. And perhaps those spiral nebulae were evenly distributed across the sky, but the stars and dust of our own galaxy obscured their detection along the plane of the Milky Way. This great debate was unresolvable at the time. 4 years after this debate, Edwin Hubble, using the 100-inch Hooker telescope at the Mount Wilson Observatory in California, identified individual stars within the spiral nebula in Andromeda, and proved beyond doubt that they must lie outside the Milky Way. The great spiral nebula in Andromeda was actually the Andromeda Galaxy. In the 100 years since, we've learned that our universe is so much larger than the Milky Way. The Andromeda Galaxy lies some 2.5 million light years distant, meaning that it takes light itself 2.5 million years to travel the 15 quintillion miles from the Andromeda Galaxy to your eye. it is easily the most distant object you can see without a telescope. Andromeda is a spiral galaxy, like the Milky Way, but far larger. The Andromeda Galaxy has maybe twice as many stars as the Milky Way. The collection of galaxies near the Milky Way is named the Local Group. Andromeda and the Milky Way are the two largest members of the Local Group. Their mutual gravity is actually pulling the two galaxies together. The Andromeda Galaxy is moving towards the Milky Way at a speed of about 70 miles every second. In some 4 billion years, the two galaxies will collide and merge, forming a larger unified galaxy. It's sometimes easy to look at where we are and think that we've got it all figured out. It was those foolish people, hundreds or thousands of years ago, that believed that silly idea. Not like us. We know so much better than to rely on superstition and intuition. How could they believe something so obviously wrong? In my grandfather's lifetime, the universe went from being a flat disk of stars called the Milky Way, with the sun near the center, to the Milky Way being but one galaxy in a universe of some 200 billion galaxies, each home to hundreds of billions of stars. Astronomy isn't a textbook filled with all the answers. It's an evolving understanding of our place in the universe, one that continues even today. We have come a long way, it's true, but there's no reason to believe that there isn't far more left to go. So if it's clear where you are tonight, go out and look for Andromeda. Follow those stars out to locate the great spiral galaxy in Andromeda, the most distant thing your eyes can see. And take a moment to consider which of those ideas that we are so convinced of now will appear foolish in 100 years. Or 1,000. That's it for today. Next time we'll continue exploring the fall constellations. This is Brian from the Delta College Planetarium, wishing you clear skies.